Bonjour tout le monde. Hello everyone. Before we get into things, I want to address recent news coming out of the UK. My thoughts are with Prime Minister Johnson and his family during this time. I've worked with Boris for some time now, and I know how committed he is to serving the people of the UK. He's a fighter, and he will be fighting now to regain his health and get back to the job he loves. Sophie and I, and all Canadians, are wishing him a speedy recovery. And to our British friends, Canadians stand with you. We will get through this together. Chaque fois qu'on apprend que quelqu'un a été hospitalisé en raison de la COVID-19, ça nous inquiète. Mais on doit se rappeler qu'on n'est pas impuissant face à la situation dans laquelle on se trouve en ce moment. Tout le monde peut contribuer à la situation, à la solution. Vous savez quoi faire. Restez chez vous le plus possible, même quand il fait beau dehors. Je sais que c'est encore plus difficile ces jours-ci avec l'arrivée du printemps, mais il faut continuer de suivre les consignes maintenant si on veut avoir des chances de pouvoir profiter de l'été dans quelques mois. Sortez seulement si vous avez besoin de faire l'épicerie et encore là, essayez d'y aller le moins possible. Ça s'applique à tout le monde, peu importe où vous vivez ou ce que vous faites dans la vie. Cela dit, certaines personnes sont en mesure d'en faire encore plus parce qu'elles possèdent des compétences ou des ressources dont on a besoin en ce moment. Par exemple, on offre des emplois à temps plein aux réservistes des forces canadiennes. Comme ça, si nos communautés ont besoin de plus de soutien, on sera prêt. Santé Canada recrute aussi des bénévoles pour prêter main forte à nos travailleurs de première ligne. Et, il y a quelques semaines, on a demandé de l'aide à des entreprises pour produire des articles qui sont très en demande. Depuis, près de 5000 entreprises canadiennes ont communiqué avec nous pour offrir leurs services. De la part de tous les Canadiens, merci. C'est vraiment inspirant de voir tant de gens qui veulent contribuer. Over the past few weeks, almost 5000 Canadian companies have stepped forward to help fight COVID-19. On behalf of all Canadians, thank you for stepping up. As countries around the world grapple with this pandemic, the demand for critical supplies like test kits, ventilators, and personal protective equipment is going up. To keep our frontline workers safe and care for Canadians with COVID-19, we need a sustainable, stable supply of these products, and that means making them at home. With our plan to mobilize industry, we're helping companies retool, repurpose, and innovate to fight COVID-19. We've already signed letters of intent with a number of partners to produce the things we need, and today we have more good news to share. We're working with Thornhill Medical, CAE, Ventilators for Canadians, and a group led by Starfish Medical to produce up to 30,000 Made in Canada ventilators. These purchases will help increase our capacity to make sure these life-saving machines are made right here at home. We're also working with Nobel Prize-winning researcher Dr. Art MacDonald, who is leading a team of scientists to develop ventilators that are easy to make. And to produce medical gowns and establish new supply chains right here in Canada, we're teaming up with over 20 companies, including Arc'teryx, Canada Goose, and Stanfield's. One thing that is particularly inspiring to see is just how many companies are not just producing these goods, but innovating. For example, Autoliv is looking to make medical gowns out of material they'd normally use to produce airbags. En même temps, notre gouvernement continue d'acheter des masques pour protéger nos professionnels de la santé qui font un travail extraordinaire. On a commandé des millions de masques chirurgicaux auprès de plusieurs compagnies canadiennes et on appuie l'entreprise Medicom qui va augmenter sa capacité de production de masques N95. On achète également du désinfectant pour les mains et Santé Canada a autorisé la vente de plus de 85 de ces produits aux Canadiens. Certains articles vont prendre plus de temps à fabriquer que d'autres, mais à chaque semaine, on franchit des étapes importantes pour augmenter notre capacité de production et je tiens à remercier le ministre Baines qui fait un excellent travail sur ça ces jours-ci. Je sais que plusieurs personnes s'inquiètent d'une pénurie de matériel. Vous regardez ce qui se passe dans d'autres pays et je comprends vos préoccupations, surtout si vous ou un proche travaillez dans le milieu de la santé. Je veux vous assurer qu'on fait tout ce qu'on peut pour éviter que ça se produise. Our government is working around the clock to ensure that our frontline workers have everything they need to save lives and stay safe. While we're working to secure critical equipment from Canadian sources, we're also in touch with other suppliers around the world who want to sell to Canada. We're expecting 500,000 masks from 3M tomorrow, and we're working as fast as we can to get them to our frontline workers. From the outset, our priority has been the health and safety of all Canadians. So whether you're making medical gowns, delivering ventilators, or treating a patient with COVID-19, we have your back. We're going to be there for you. We also have a three-point economic plan. It supports business owners, including through new loans, while safeguarding jobs with the wage subsidy and helping those who no longer have a paycheck with the CERB. Yesterday evening, our government proactively shared our proposed legislation on wage subsidy with opposition parties. I know House leaders will be speaking throughout the day to reach an agreement for the House of Commons to quickly pass this legislation, which will give much-needed financial support to Canadian workers while helping employers to keep their staff on the payroll. A lot of work has been done since we announced our plan to subsidize wages. We continue to rely on your input and feedback as we refine it, and we'll have more details to share very soon. Yesterday was also the first day people could apply to receive the CERB. On that note, I want to recognize the tremendous work done by the public service, who processed hundreds of thousands of claims. They're working around the clock to get Canadians the help they need as quickly as possible. And I also want to remind everyone that if you were born in April, May, or June, today's the day you can apply. Finally, as some of you will know, today marks World Health Day and National Caregiver Day. This year, I'm especially grateful for our healthcare professionals and caregivers who are working day and night to keep us safe and to care for our most vulnerable. As Canada confronts this pandemic, many have pointed to our healthcare system as a major asset. Ours is a country where health is a right rather than a privilege, and that's something of which we can all be proud. But our healthcare system is only as strong as the people it employs. Whether you're a doctor or a nurse, someone who keeps our hospital clean, or a home care worker, thank you for taking such good care of us. Thank you for everything you've done over the years to help so many of us start a family, overcome an illness, and enjoy longer, healthier lives. We do not need a pandemic or a special day to recognize your essential contributions to this country, but I hope all Canadians will join me in expressing our deepest gratitude. I hope Canadians honk a little louder when your shift ends today and add another rainbow to their window. Du fond du cœur, merci à tous nos aidants naturels et à nos professionnels de la santé. Merci.